diffusion / osmosis.
Chapter 3, cohesion.
Chapter 4, adhesion. Chapter 5, isocinity.
In Chapter 6, floating of ice on liquid water.
So Chapter 1 is about universal solvent, a liquid that is completely a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances is called a solution. The dissolving agent of a solution is a solvent. The substance that is dissolved is the solute. And nothing works better than water as a universal solvent. Hydrophilic substances have an affinity for water. Hydrophobic substances, non-ionic and non-polar, repels water. Water is called the universal solvent because it is capable of dissolving more substances than any other liquid. And this means that everywhere that has water in the air, ground, or through our bodies, it takes along valuable chemicals, minerals, and nutrients.
Chapter 2, we will be learning about diffusion and
osmosis. And biologists define osmosis as the diffusion of water across a selectively permeable membrane.
And then in a cell, water always moves to reach an equal concentration on both sides of the membrane, moving from high to low. In order for diffusion to occur, there must be a concentration gradient. And then our diagram, this is where the solution is not as concentrated, and this is where it is more concentrated. And then we go over here and it shows how the solution that is more concentrated comes over to the less concentrated to make it an equal amount of concentration.
Chapter 3, cohesion. Water molecules stay close to each other as a result of hydrogen bonding. Even though the arrangement of molecules in a sample of liquid water is constantly changing, at any given moment, many of the molecules are linked by hydrogen bonds. These links make water more structured than most liquids. The hydrogen bonds hold the substance together, and this is called cohesion. Cohesion contributes to the transport of water and dissolving nutrients against gravity in plants. And here we have our cohesion buddies.
Bonded with hydrogen.
Thank you. Chapter 4, adhesion and surface tension. Adhesion is the clinging of one substance to another. Adhesion of water to cell walls by hydrogen bonds helps counter the downward pull of gravity. Surface tension is a measure of how difficult it is to stretch or break the surface of a liquid. Water has a greater surface tension than most other liquids. There's a diagram of a water molecule clinging onto a leaf. Chapter 5, osmosis. The ability of water to stabilize temperature stems from its relative absorbed or lost for 1 gram of that substance that changes temperature by 1 degree Celsius. The specific heat of water is 1 calorie per gram and per degree Celsius. Compared to other substances, water has an unusually high specific heat. Because of the high specific heat of water relative to other materials, water will change its temperature less when it absorbs or loses a given amount.
Chapter 6, floating of ice on liquid water. Water is one of the few This means ice floats on water. This is due to hydrogen bonding. At temperatures above 4 degrees Celsius, water behaves like other liquids, expanding as it warms and contracting as it cools. As the temperature falls from 4 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius, water begins to freeze because more and more of its molecules are moving slowly to break hydrogen bonds. Floating ice becomes the barrier that protects the water.
So chapter 1 is about universal solvent, which is a liquid that is completely... Oh my god, wait, I messed up.
Chapter 2
In chapter 6, floating of ice water. Oh wait, I messed up.